Today, aviation and defense universe is interviewing Major Ameek Pal Kaur from the Indian Army, the Sappers and the Bombay Sappers of the Corps of Engineers. Ameek, we welcome you for this session which is being recorded for the bicentennial celebrations of the Bombay Sappers.
Thank you so much, sir. It's a privilege.
Tell me, Ameek, how did you decide to join the Corps of Engineers?
Indian Army has never been a job option for me or for my family. It is something that has been passed on to us by our forefathers. I'm a third generation. So it was never a job option. It was something that I wanted to do as a part of the family tradition. That's how I joined.
Ameek, I know that your dad is also a Bombay Sapper.
Sir.
Was this Bombay Sapper forced on you or it was your choice?
I would not call it a choice. I would call it a privilege that I get to be a part of the same corps and then the same group as my father. I am very proud of the fact that we could both wear the uniform and salute the same flag. It's a privilege.
Oh, very nice. Ameek, traditionally, the Indian Army, or any army for that matter in the world, is male dominated, or male forte. What is your experience on this aspect?
The induction of women officers started decades back. And when they had inducted long time back, I'm sure things were different. And as on date, we are on a much better platform. We have much better opportunities. So we are pretty happy and content where we are. It will be incorrect to probably compare ourselves with the lady officers or the woman officers who will get inducted in the next 20 years. So as on date, things are much better and we are very happy. We are getting equal opportunities. We are being motivated equally. So yes, I will not say that it is male dominated, because whatever little I have achieved so far, it has been possible only because of the foresight of the male officers I have been placed under command. So I would go by that.
Oh, that's nice to hear. Ameek, tell me, is there any difference in the allocation of work, in the army, in the units, when it comes to division of work between the male officers or men of the male officers and you?
Again, I can just speak of my regiment here. I'm proudly commissioned into the 1st Bridging Regiment of the Indian Army, and I have never seen this happening, neither in my unit nor in the corps for sure. And I've served under two commanding officers who have both given me equal opportunities. So whatever little, as I iterated, I've achieved is because of their foresight and their motivation and their faith in my capabilities. When I was under command, the first CO, I got the opportunity to represent myself in the RD parade. When I was under command, the second CO, I got the opportunity to represent myself in an Indo-Russian exercise. More so, when the regiment goes for the exercise, we all go along, we all work equally, and there is no division of work based on gender. I'm sure when the capability is there, anybody would want to give the work to somebody who can do it. And it is not gender based.
Oh, that's very nice to hear.
Sir.
Tell me one thing. Now, since we have talked about your early years, let's talk something about your career.
Sir. So, I was commissioned into the Corps of Engineers in March 2013. And after that, I've had one tenure in my regiment. That is where I can say that I've learned the maximum. I got the maximum exposure of not only the army, but also the technical aspects of what the regiment is bound to do. I was fortunate enough to, as it rated, represent the nation in RD parade. and then be a part of a very elite exercise, the Indo-Russian exercise. Post that, I went to the center. I've had one tenure there in Bombay Engineers Group. And that is where I saw how humble and how brave our troops are. You know, it is a privilege to command troops that come from such a warrior lineage. You know, we have the Marathas and the Sikhs, and they have so much to teach us. Simple yet happy living is something that I learnt from them. It was more of a student's experience in the center than that, you know, of an instructor. I was always learning so much about the core, about their trades, about how can you become a good leader. And then I went for my MES tenure. That is where my technical proficiency, I would say, increased, because I could apply my engineering knowledge to the best of my capabilities. I could see things happening on ground, and it added a lot to my knowledge. First from there, then I went for my junior command course, where with the grace of God, I got an instructor's grading and was awarded the best woman officer. And I'm here today, sitting in front of you, sir, giving this elite interview.
Ameek, it appears that you've been first in many.
Again, by the grace of God, sir. I'm a silver medalist in the Corps of Engineers, and yes, I'm the first woman officer to become the flag officer for beating the retreat in 2015. And it's because of the blessings of elders like you.
No, we are honored that you are in the Corps of Engineers, and that to Bombay Sappers, my regiment.
Yes, and, yes, very much.
And your dad's regiment. Ameek, now I have one this thing for you, that you know, now many girls are there, young girls, and they're double-minded whether join army or not join army. What message will you like to share with them?
I just have one line for them. They should follow their heart. When I had joined my college, I wanted to pursue mechanical engineering. And believe you me, I was the only girl in about 500 boys in the entire college. Initially, everybody told me that this will not be possible. One teacher came from somewhere who was not even from my college, and my father asked him the same thing. You know, not many girls are joining mechanical engineering. Should she join? He said one thing that I listened to at that point in time, and I've been following it till date. He said, follow your heart, the scope will follow. So that is what I have to tell all the girls and even the boys. If you want to join the Indian Army, please go ahead. If your heart is there in it, please go ahead. I speak from my own experience that it is the best profession that I could become a part of. And it doesn't only give me a job assurance, a safety, but it gives me a very good sense of living, a true sense of belief, and it also gives me the best of what I can ask for. Professional competency, the various adventures of the army, it shows you around the country so well. So if you have it in your heart, all that I have to say is, you don't have a better option than this. Come, join.
Wonderful message, Ameek.
Thank you so much,
sir. I think those who will hear this would definitely join Indian Army, Corps of Engineers, and the Bombay Sappers.
And the Bombay Sappers. Sapper may sapper, the Bombay Sappers.
The Bombay Sappers. Ameek, it's been very interesting and wonderful hearing your story. What the ADU wishes you is that your graph is on the up, up, and up. Great.
Thank you so much, sir.
And considering that we in the Indian Army or any army would like to, you know, have a stint with a foreign mission.
Thank you so much, sir.
So we pray and wish that one day you also get an opportunity for a mission abroad, which will add feathers to your cap.
Thank you so much, sir.
So much colorful.
Thank you so much, sir.
Wish you all the best.
Thank you.